Ibrahim! Ibrahim! You can come back.
Assalamu alaikum.
Wa alaikum assalam.
I know you're tired, you're full, and you're ready to go to sleep, so I'm not gonna prolong this lecture. Not even a lecture. I was asked to speak about courage, and I guess it probably would have been better to talk about it before we decided to go to the slopes, but since we're all a group of youth, I felt, and we're in America, I guess to me I can see that trying to give you something that we can take home now that we're going home anyway, and that is that we have to have courage as Muslims. It's something that is very praiseworthy. One of the things that the Prophet ﷺ was known for, that he was never a coward, and that there are many instances where he showed great signs of courage, whether it's dealing with his trials and tribulations, or even in a famous story where they heard a sound in the forest and everyone was afraid to go and inquire what it was. And when they finally actually went to the forest, they found the Prophet ﷺ was riding a wild horse. And they found that, so he was the first person, he was never a coward. And there are many instances that I could go and start talking about how the Prophet ﷺ was so courageous in many instances. But the thing I wanted to stress is that here in America, being a Muslim, I'm sure all of us face that challenge of how do we practice our religion at the same time doing things that are not accepted by mainstream society. And it requires us that same sense of courage and having the ability to look past what people are looking at us for and knowing what to do and what we're doing is right in order to overcome. And if you take the examples of what we just did today, we can learn from them. And that is when you are faced with a challenge, you know, for most of us, some of us it was the first time you did either skiing or snowboarding, or for some of us it was the first time you did a certain distance or a certain slope. So maybe you were only used to doing the medium slopes, so you went to the higher ones. You saw that there's that initial fear that we all have. And even in the Quran, and if you look at it, that many of the prophets, they all had a sense of fear. Fear is natural. You look at Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, when he first got the message, he was very nervous. He didn't know what to do. Even Musa, when Musa was given the message, he didn't know what to do, and he asked Allah to cure him of his speech impediment, to make his brother Aaron or Harun to come along with him. So to be afraid is not something that is dispraiseworthy, but the real problem is when you allow that fear to keep you from doing what is right. And for us here in America, I think that's the biggest challenge that we have. That we may know what is right, and we may know that we should do it, but because we're afraid of the response we're going to get from other people, we sometimes lose that courage. But we have to be just like we were today on the slopes, where we're willing to take that risk. Because we have to, what I can see, wallahu a'lam, I didn't read it in a book or hear a sheikh say it, but if you look at it, there are basically two main principles that we have to have in order to conquer any fear. And the first principle that I think we need to have is you have to have the belief in whatever goal that you're searching for. You have to truly believe that what you are trying to get is something that is worthy of getting. I hope you understand what I'm saying. Is that clear or unclear? If you don't have sincere belief in what you're doing, you're never truly going to be able to overcome whatever fear that is behind it. And the second thing is a strong determination to achieve that goal. Without these two principles, I doubt it, a person will ever be able to be successful. If you don't see the greater goal of what you're trying to get as important, then you're not going to be able to overcome the challenges. And if you're not determined, through the challenges, then you're always going to fail and stop whenever something comes into your way. And that is why, if you look at it, when the Prophet ﷺ, he was in the famous Battle of Uhud, he took the advice of some of the companions, even the younger companions. He disregarded the advice, or he chose the advice of the young rather than the advice of the old. And he did this, and they went, as you all know the story of Uhud, they went out to the battle. Many of the older companions, they advised the Prophet ﷺ to stay in Medina and fight from inside Medina. But the youth, they were so invigorated, and they wanted to participate and help Islam, that they said, no, we want to take the battle to the enemy. But after the battle, as we all know what happened, many of them felt depressed or saddened as to what happened. And so Allah told him in the Quran that they should not be saddened, they should not be worried about what happened, they should not be regretful, that basically giving reassuring their qadr and what Allah says, or what Allah has decreed. And then he says something amazing. He tells them, or he tells the Prophet ﷺ, that you should still continue in seeking the advice of your companions. But here's the key that I'm getting at. He says, وَإِذَا عَزَمْتَ فَتَوَكَّلْ عَلَى اللَّهِ. That if you've made a decision, then you should just rely on Allah. And the point that I'm getting at, brothers and sisters, there's no sisters here, huh? That the point that I'm getting at is that whenever you have a goal in mind and you made your determination, this is what you're looking for and you're striving for, you just have to put your reliance on Allah. You put your tawakkul on Allah, and then you don't look at that fear. Because I'm sure for any of us who today you decided not to do something that you wanted to do, it was because you looked at what might happen that was bad more than you thought of the goal. You thought, well, if I fall, I'm going to break something, I'm going to hurt something, I'm afraid of falling, I'm going to be embarrassed. And so you allowed the fear to overcome, well, what if I have fun, what if I can do it? So when you don't have that tawakkul, you lose sight of the goal, then you won't be able to accomplish anything. And that's one of the tricks of shaitan. And that's one of the greatest tricks of shaitan, is that he makes you depressed or he makes you fearful, and that fear is what causes you to lose your connection to Allah and lose your reliance and make you not do what you think is right. Now for us, I said the whole point of talking about courage was to talk about how can we be courageous here in America, is that we have to look at two major things. That we have our goal in life, as we want to be doctors, we want to be, you know, successful people in life, but we can't allow that goal to take us away from the ultimate goal. And that our future is not necessarily, or is not the end of, okay, now I'm a great doctor, I'm a rich person, I'm a famous person, I'm a successful person, whatever I wanted to do in life, I did it. That's not the end, brothers. That's not going to determine your real fate. As we all know, being here is temporary. No matter how young you are today, you should never think that, you know, this type of talk is something I'll worry about in the future when I get older. And if you do not prepare now for your future, just like our parents tell us now, if you don't go to school, if you don't do well, then you're not going to have a future, our real future in Jannah, inshallah. If we're not preparing for it now, then we're not going to get that opportunity. And if we start preparing now, we'll keep it in our minds that ultimately whatever happens in this life is superficial. It doesn't really have substance or meaning if we are not prepared, or if we have not done what will get us to that permanent, eternal, or forever happiness. And that if we are truly sincere to ourselves, so if we have the true belief in what we're saying, that we truly believe that there is a gender.